Hi everyone, my name is Paul Kanan. I am a producer, a performer, and an arts educator. My job is kind of a mixed bag of all these skills that I picked up along the way, and I get to apply them in different ways every day. When I was growing up, I really just wanted to perform on Broadway and live in New York City. So I trained and I auditioned and was lucky enough to actually work on Broadway. I did 8 shows a week for 15 years, which felt like a long time. But I did shows like Legally Blonde, Thoroughly Modern Millie, and Kinky Boots, and a few others. And then a few years ago, I transitioned into more of the production end of show business. One way I did that, I started an arts education organization because I've always been obsessed with education. It's called Take It From the Top, and I take Broadway actors, writers, choreographers, directors, and we come to Michigan and Florida and other places and work with aspiring young performers in musical theater. And then I launched a choreography licensing company that takes original Broadway choreography, and we make instructional videos of the steps so that schools and theater groups can learn and perform that choreography. It's all very confusing, but it's my life. So schedule-wise, I'm kind of in charge of my own day-to-day. I take on whatever projects I want and figure out how to best work out my day to stay on top of everything. Typical day for me is pretty much happening here in my apartment in New York. I check emails, I hop on different Zoom calls, probably like just a lot of you, and I get ready for whatever comes next. Today I worked with an organization called the Penguin Project, which I love. They empower children with disabilities and special needs through theater. And I'm lining up some artists and editing videos for an event for them. I usually go to the gym somewhere in there because you got to stay in shape. And then the rest of my day I worked on a Take It From the Top program we're doing with the Wharton Center, which offers a year-long virtual arts education program, which I love because I get to connect with my awesome Michigan people. What I love most about my job is I really enjoy working with people who share my passion for theater and art. I also love to travel. My job takes me to cool places. And I love just creating new opportunities for people to perform and learn about the performing arts. Every summer at the Wharton Center, we work with about 150 local students who come from all different levels and experience, and we work all week, and at the end of the week, we put on a big show at the Cobb stage, which is huge. And I just love seeing the students get applause and feel the energy of a live performance. What I look for when I am hiring somebody, I guess if I'm running a audition in New York, I'm looking for the best actor, singer, dancer for a job. But for my education stuff, I'm looking for teachers who actually care about teaching and that work well with students and can translate what they know to somebody else, which is always important. Other than that, the fact that theater is kind of at a standstill can be tricky. What I like least, performing arts can sometimes lead to egos. I don't want to work with people who have big egos. I want to work with collaborators that are creative and positive. Education-wise, my background, I have a BFA in musical theater. But I started taking voice lessons and dancing when I was about 11 or 12. I feel like you're never too young to explore the arts and you're never too old to just keep on appreciating and supporting it. And I knew this was the career for me because whether on Broadway stage or in my high school auditorium, I just felt the happiest when I was on stage. So luckily, I was able to turn that passion into a career. So whatever career you pursue, make sure that you are passionate about it and you work hard every day at it. So that's me and my mini jobs. I wish you all well with your education, virtual or not, and hopefully I'll see you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.